what is information technology. It's also referred to as ICT information and communication technology. I don't think I have to define the software. Do I have to define proprietary software? I found some statistics. Women in IT in general, you can see in the US, and these figures are from 2004, they are about 17% who follow computer science courses. And in the European Union, it is somewhere between 15 and 25. And the 35% is mainly based on figures from the UK. Women working as IT specialists. In the USA in 2005, the IT industry shows 25%. The European Union, I didn't find more recent figures. They certainly exist, but they are well written. I believe in 2009, so it is about a fourth of all IT. Why aren't there more women? Women in free software. There was a technical article in 2005 that stated that there are approximately 25% female among proprietary software developers. And two studies showed that there are between 1.5 and 3.4% only of free software. There is a big difference. Well, this difference can be explained by various reasons. First, mainly the CS courses follow proprietary software, because most of the universities in France do use proprietary. So it's women use proprietary software more than free software, also because in studies it is still widely used. It begins to change, but when I compare, for example, to the status school in Switzerland, it seems still to be a very, very, very proprietary government. So free software is not necessarily something you find easily in English. Then why are there so little women in IT? Well, it is due to historical reasons, it is due to cultural reasons, and the reasons, and it is mainly due, in my opinion, to educational reasons. Girls are still in 21st century trained and oriented women. This can be seen easily when you take a survey. When do girls first have access to computers? Average age is 14 years old, whereas That's why it is so important that we do mentoring. Because the teacher what happens for astronauts. How many female astronauts do you know? Very little. And, oh, surprisingly, the last female astronaut who has been to space was a teacher. What did she do? She gave a lesson from space. How very good. Well, did they take this woman on board because she was a teacher? Or did they take this woman on board because she was a woman, so she goes on the quota, and, well, she could do something hard, difficult, so let's take a teacher. Yeah. But it's still very, very surprising that even in these fields where no women are supposed to have quotas for women, something that is not very widely used in European countries. If you go to the space industry, they are very, very, very. Why are women not choosing these countries? Well, because they are not offered the opportunity. They are not shown the possibilities. And maybe because they are not. Why shouldn't women be interested in choosing their careers? And here comes one of the problems we see very, very often. One of the answers is very
happened this year. But I was absolutely lucky, and I was, must say, a little bit shocked, because I thought, my God, I mean, there are so many dating possibilities on the internet. Why does this man think that I am in this technical channel giving technical advice? Because I'm a mate. This happens very, very often. And women are geeks too. They're not simply girlfriends. This is something we should try to establish. But the problem is, it is very difficult. And every day we find, again and again, we are confronted with the same problem. In free software, it is worse. Because in free software, it admits that you have to be extremely strong to be able to do this. It's even higher than anywhere else. So the barriers, the boundaries are higher. And instead of doing what free software was meant to do, which means with widespread and wider use, it becomes even more restrictive. So, preventing women from doing free software is totally counterproductive. This means that you're feeding it into five countries. Who knows if this continues? One day we have only one person who is doing free software, the others who are new to doing property. This is not the aim of free software. There is a fact, because of all these cultural, educational and historical backgrounds, many women today do not have strong programs. And what is bad coding? Indian women once said this in a group, in a mailing list, excuse me. A documentation, a code which did not follow documentation rules above. So we can push, educate them. Everybody has to become a great artist. Not everybody has to still become a artist. And everybody has to still become this sensitive answer. But this is not gender dependent. We can take action in professional surroundings. Open the way to every profession for everybody, not only for men, or only for women, or only for non-descendants people. This gap is gender gap is are or are not. Diminish the matches in the software community, which there is active matches based on who you are, but for those who have followed the community in the last 4 years, you have to find the strange things, like death to the environment. Do you remember that? But it also means that we should not fall into the trap and end up with exaggerated criminal behavior. And that is one of the things why what is a woman able to do? They can thank you. statistics you have made yourself. They tend to risk more, that's true. They tend to risk more. Not necessarily do, but they do. It is more common. Much like the name of the Paxton. Because the Paxton means they are hackers, but they are also depends how you spell it, how you pronounce it. And of course there are a few others, male women, Paxton women, and even the open source initiative has a name. But they are quite few. Which does not mean that we stay close into the truth. You only exist within the model. I think if a woman goes into one of these groups, she can also go into a non-gender group. The same for men. Of course.